Hi everyone, this is Maya and welcome to our channel. So in today's episode, I would be telling my experience of visiting Jagannath Puri temple. So in the previous episode, you must have seen what are the places you can visit in Puri for one day. And if you have not seen that, the link is in the description. Please do watch. So from the place we were staying, we took an e-rickshaw and reached till the main streets of the temple. And everywhere there you can find this famous breakfast called Dahi Vada Aloo Dum, and it is a must try dish. It is really very, very tasty. This is the first time I actually had it, and so it is basically Dahi Vada dipped in buttermilk, and they serve it with Aloo Dum and onions and some seasoning, which makes it really very, very tasty. And trust me, it is not at all heavy to your stomach. It's actually very light and you feel very nice. So it's good that we had breakfast because we didn't know how much time we are gonna take to reach inside the temple. It was a Diwali day when we visited Puri temple for the first time, and we never knew that it's actually a very important day for the temple. And my father had a friend who is a priest inside the temple, and he took us to the main sanctum. There is a ritual in which they keep a mirror in front of the deity and consider that mirror as the deity, and they perform all the cleaning rituals like giving bath to the deity, also brushing the teeth, and lot of other things like combing the hair. All those things were done to the mirror. I consider myself very lucky that I could see that event in so much of peace, because now it is impossible because of the number of devotees visiting each day in Jagannath Puri temple. The major difference is the amount of devotees from the past 18 years. It has drastically increased. And we actually decided to visit the temple by 8 o'clock in the morning, and we had to stand in the queue for almost 4 hours, and then is when we could actually get the darshan. And if you take a special darshan, which will cost you some money, but we took a free darshan, so we stood in the queue and it was so much rush. People were really pushing and we were really crushed inside the temple. That's what you can say. And after waiting for so long, you can't even stand in the sanctum for 2 seconds. They will just shoo you off because of so much of the crowd. And we didn't even go on a peak day. So this is a normal day crowd which I'm talking about. So you have to carry water bottles with you because it gets really very hot inside the temple, even outside. So they have these tents which are made, and it's like some 8 or 9 tents before you enter the temple. So each tent is like a batch. So they send only that batch of people once inside the temple, and once the darshan is done, they will send the next batch. That's why it takes so much time to actually go and get the darshan. You have to be very careful when you enter inside because there's always running water and you can slip. Because of the crowd, you can also feel suffocated. So anytime if you want to come out, please come out. And you can go later when the crowd is less, which is very rare. But be prepared that you have to go in the crowd and get the darshan. Even though it was so crowded, it was actually a very peaceful darshan of Lord Jagannath. And we felt very blessed. Even if it was for 5 to 10 seconds, it was really very good. And because we have been to this temple very peacefully before, we know how the deities actually look and how tall they are. So the main deity in the temple is Lord Jagannath, Subhadra and Balabhadra. The deities are actually made with neem wood and are actually 2.5 to 3 meters in height. So there are a few facts which are very mysterious about Jagannath Puri temple, and when you actually visit there, you can see that the flag on top of the main sanctum flies in opposite direction of the wind. It's weird, but it's true. So there's no shadow of the temple which falls on the ground, probably because of the way the temple is made. Talking about the second largest temple kitchen in the world, Jagannath Puri Temple serves 56 delicacies to Lord Jagannath throughout the day. So it is said that the food is made in a very special way, wherein 7 pots are kept on top of each other and firewood is kept to cook it. And the mystery is always the topmost pot gets cooked first and then the later pots. So the Mahaprasad comes in 2 kinds, Sukhila and Sankhuri. Sukhila means dry, which is mostly the dry delicacies which are served to Lord Jagannath. Sankhuri includes the rice and other vegetable and dal curries which is given to Lord Jagannath. And there's also one more mystery, that every day it is the same quantity of prasadam which is cooked in the kitchen, and it is never that the food is wasted or anybody is unfed. The last time when we went to Jagannath Puri temple, we had the prasadam outside the temple. My dad's friend actually got it for us. But this time we were on our own and we had to explore how are we gonna have the prasadam. So now there is a place called Anand Bazaar where all the prasadam is actually very neatly kept and you can actually buy it. I would suggest that instead of buying the whole package for 250 to 500 rupees, it is better to go to Anand Bazaar and taste whatever you like, because they have kept everything there and you can try whichever you want. Inside the temple, you would find a lot of priests asking for money. We would suggest that be polite and say no. And whatever donations you want to give, you can put it in the donation box rather than giving it to the pundits. So the pundits or the priests here are called the pandas, and they would also force you to get the food coupon which will give you all the delicacies, but that doesn't happen. It's basically a pot of rice and 3-4 variety of curries and probably 1 sweet. But if you go to Anand Bazaar, you can actually taste each and everything and also buy extra to take it to your home. As I am a very big Krishna devotee, I feel very blessed each time I go to Jagannath Puri temple. So photography is strictly prohibited inside the temple, and also there are rules like you cannot wear anything which is leather. So keep your belts and your wallet in your hotel, or there are also places where you can keep it in the locker. So that's what we did.
Your shoes and mobile in such places, they'll take a minimal amount of 10 rupees or 20 rupees.
So basically my father and my brother didn't wear belt and they didn't carry their wallet, so they just carried cash. And also you have to be very careful because it's so much crowded. There are a lot of pickpocketers as well, so be careful of that. And you're not allowed to carry any bag. Even if you're carrying the bag, they have this checking system where you have to open your bag and show. So it's better that you don't carry. And there are a lot of people selling water in between, so you can buy the water bottles from them and have water. But don't carry any edible items or anything which can cause you a security issue. In the streets near the temple, you can find a lot of souvenirs and puja items. And you can also buy gifts for your loved ones from here.
You get ghee khaja from Narsingh Sweet, which is just opposite to the temple. So there's the temple. And here you can see a lot of sweet shops. Among this, you can go to this one to have the ghee khaja.
After visiting the temple, we were really very tired. We just went back to our hotel and just rested till evening. And in the evening, we went to Swargdwar beach. And this is the kind of beach which we like. So we also saw this sand art, which is very unique to Puri Beach. Earlier it was only made in Puri Beach. Now you can see it all over every beach in India. And we ended the day by having dinner at Wildgrass restaurant, and the food was really authentic. We really loved the ambience and the service. We would really recommend you to go there. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next episode. Bye bye.